Hello, Love Bugs. Coach Kara here. So today I want to talk about another dating topic, and that is he no longer chases me. All right, so just wanted to share this video with you. Another one of our Love Bugs kind of mentioned this issue, and I just figured that I would, you know, touch on it a little just so you all could also have some understanding and maybe clarification as well, okay? All right, so let's just get started. So perhaps you and your guy or your person have been involved for quite some time, or maybe not even. Typically what happens in a connection when you're dealing with two people who are not evolved and they are not at the highest level of themselves as any human could be, right? So what happens, you have your dating challenges, you know, you're on and off, you may have disagreements that never quite get resolved, and you continue to go on in your situation. All right, that happens. So when you're dealing with a person who is not apt for growth or change in any fashion, yet you are, you may seek that, okay? And you may, as a partner and just as a person, want to better yourself, and you go after that growth. You may do some introspection and work on your self-esteem and that sort of thing. And so what happens is, while you're working on yourself and you're trying to do better and maybe even escape the situation, which is what I'm going to get to momentarily, your person may see that. They may see growth and change, and that you're moving out and away from anything that is going towards toxicity. And they may not like that. Okay, it becomes uncomfortable for them. So if you're trying to make better moves and made better choices in your life, whereas your person has always made poor choices and poor decisions. And the reason for that is, when it comes to most guys, they rely on their ego. Okay, so something has to feed that ego in order for them to make most decisions in their lives. And here is where we are now. This is one decision that they're going to have to make based on their ego. If they see you trying to move differently and you're trying to progress with yourself, with your life, with your career, your education, they see that you're trying to get out of this funk. This is when the manipulation comes into play. They may, you know, manipulate the situation to their benefit, to where it makes it seem as though you may be the problem, or there may be arguments to where it tries to keep you down. They may not want to see you grow. And then, of course, they have always chased after you. When you guys, you know, were initially dating or whatever, you may not want to talk to them for a couple days, and they may call you or come by, whatever, do the whole little thing that most guys do in these sort of situations. And they've done that. But now they can see this change within you. They see that you're trying to escape. And so now that the tables may be turning, they're going to do everything that they can to keep you there. When you leave and you're gone for good, a guy knows that. He can tell and he can sense when someone is not going to return. And the only reason why he will not chase you is because he himself is not ready to change. He himself knows that he could never live up to that type of change without coming off as disingenuous. It would be a behavior pattern that one could easily see through. You know, he can't even fake it. So because he's not willing to put in the effort to grow, to make changes, to better himself, to change his mentality, his behaviors, get out of old, you know, patterns, he's too lazy to do that, or just really don't give a damn about changing to be a better person, you know, become better evolved in life, he's not going to chase you because of that. He sees you're headed towards a better way of life, you know, that you're headed towards growth in every aspect. He cannot compete with that, because he's relied on his ego most of his life with most decision making and, you know, his choices. Now this is where he's stumped. okay, I know I can't measure. I know I can't do that, what she's doing. She's starting to look stronger now. She's making better decisions. I can see that. I cannot compete with that. And that is merely due to poor esteem, you know, a lack of self-respect. And I can continuously go on, but it equates to that. Low vibrational. Another reason why he may not chase you is because, well, he simply knows that you have always deserved better. You weren't aware of your self-worth initially. See, as I always say, a wolf always knows his prey. Like, he knew from the very beginning that either you weren't keen or wise enough to detect danger at first sight. He knew that, and he took advantage of that. And he forced you to come in, charmed you in, did whatever, sexed you down, did all of that, got you involved into a bunch of mess because you weren't smart enough to recognize the danger at first glance. Okay? And that you would be stupid enough to stay in it once he reeled you in. It was all tactic. He knew that from the very beginning. And now that you've gotten out of that mindset, you may have found yourself, you're growing. That is something you can't compete with. You can't compete with strength, inner strength. And because he doesn't have that to push forward, to want to do better himself, he'll just let you go. You've always deserved better. He knew this from the beginning. The strong always prey on the weak. But now that you are probably showing signs of strength, hey, I'll let you go. I can't compete with that. You're beginning to see your worth. And so this is what many guys do. So if you've been wondering, oh my gosh, why is he not coming after me? Maybe he doesn't love me. Yeah, he does care about you. I won't say love. We can't put love in that. But care, yes, he may have some strong feelings for you. But at the same time, he knows, and he always have known, that you need something more. You deserve better. I'll just let you go and get that. Meanwhile, while you're doing that, I'll just go find someone else because I'm afraid of being alone. Because if I'm alone, I'm going to actually discover who I really am. I don't want to see that. I don't want to be faced with the kind of monster I really am. So I'll find someone else who's going to entertain madness with me. Someone who is also low vibrational. Okay? I'll find someone who can be equally as toxic as I am if it has gotten to that point. Yeah, that's what I'll do. And I'll continuously do that on and on and on until I begin to realize within myself that I need to make a change to be happy. All right. So that's basically what it is, my loves. Yeah. So if your guy is no longer chasing you, it's not because he may not care or doesn't want you. He just already knew and has always known that he never deserved you. Like I always have said, when you know your worth, you will never be in the business of keeping someone who does not deserve to be kept. Okay? All right. So that is all for now, my love. I'll leave that right there for now. If you need further dating coaching, all of my information will be linked down below. I thank you always for joining me. That is all for now. Until next time.